Each creditor has their own individual rights to protect themselves against being treated worse if you reorganize the business than if you were to liquidate the business. It's considered a fundamental property right in the United States. In creditor treatment, however, once it exceeds that threshold of being at least as much as the creditor would get in liquidation, is done through a plan, and that plan is approved by voting, and once it's approved, it binds all of the creditors. So dissenting creditors to the plan can have their day in court and can be heard, but they still, in the end, can be controlled by the vote of the other creditors and by the court. If the class of creditors, and we divide into classes, so there'll be secured classes and maybe two or three unsecured classes. Two-thirds in amount and a majority in number need to affirm the plan, and if so, they can be bound by the vote. But important and maybe different in United States bankruptcy law is even if a class votes against the plan, if the court determines that the plan treats that class in a fair and equitable manner, then the court can approve the plan and bind the class even if the class has voted no. So at least one class has to vote yes. But once one class votes yes, the court can decide between competing classes what is fair and equitable.